Hello everyone, my name is Suman Shah, and in the series of Oracle e-Business Suite, today we will create chart of account in general ledger. So first we will create accounting organization structure, then we will create a segment and then value set, and then segment values. We'll provide the segment values. So a segment can be created up to 30 max, and minimum should be two segments. That is, one is company, which will have a balancing segment, primary balancing segment qualifier, and the another one is account, which will give a natural account qualifier. And there are two types of qualifiers, that is flex field qualifiers and assigned to the segment, and that is balancing segment and the natural account segment, which is mandate. Two is the mandate one, and the other are cost center segment qualifier, then intercompany segment qualifier, and then secondary tracking segment qualifier and management segment qualifier. This is assigned to the segment. And then there is a segment qualifier assigned to the segment values, balancing segment, then allow posting and allow budgeting. These two values will activate. And when we apply natural account segment, then allow posting, allow budgeting. Apart from that, account type, third party account control, and reconcile will also get activated. So we will navigate the navigation process. We will log in with the general accounting super user responsibility. First, we will create structure name, that is accounts key flex field. The navigation is navigation setup, financial flex field key segment. Similarly, I have given the navigation below. Then we will create a segment name, that is company, division, account, product, intercompany, and so on. We can create up to 30 segments, but it is ideally recommended by the Oracle to have a 6 to 9 segment, considering the future segment also. So the navigation for that is setup financial flex view key segment, and then we will create a value set, that is company, division, accounts, and so on. The navigation is setup financial flex field key segment and value set. Then we will assign values to the segment, and the navigation is setup financial flex field key segment summary in the segment summary window. And after that, we will assign segment qualifiers. The segment qualifiers we will assign. So setup financial flex field key segment and segment flex field qualifier is the navigation. Then we will freeze the flex field definition with allow dynamic insert and then compile. So how we will do that in the application? We will navigate to the application now. navigated to my application. And general as a super user, is my responsibility. And then go to setup, financials, tax field, and then key. And now we will select segment. We will search for general ledger. So general ledger accounting key flex field, general ledger GL ledger flex field, and there is a general ledger reporting attribute accounting. So we will select the general ledger accounting key flex field. The flex field, accounting flex field is mentioned. And now from here, we will select add. Add. And we will provide our structure name. So my structure name will be OTS underscore counting underscore FIELD field and tab out. Yeah, and then I will provide the name operations counting so and save. So it has been saved now. Now you can see there is a freeze flex field definition, cross validation segment, freeze roller group, and segment separator, that is dash, period, pipe, and custom. So we will select the dash one. And allow dynamic insertion. So before allowing this, all the things, we will go directly to the segments as we want to create a segments now. So quickly, I will create a segment. So I will create a 5 segment now. One, that is CONPNY company. Window prompt is company. I can say company. And column, I will give segment one. You can see up to 30 segments. Here we say 30 segments is allowed. So I am selecting the first segment, that is segment one. And say okay. Then I will select two, that is division. Division, and that is DIV in short, window prompt, and that will be the segment 2. From LOV, I will select segment 2. There we are. Then, and 3, that is accounts, account, ACCT. And that will be the my segment 3. Here we are. And after that, 4 is my product. segment as product. Product. Product, I will say PDT, product. And that will be my segment 4. Segment 4. And then I will select 5th as intercompany. Company. And IC will be the window prompt, and that will be the segment 5. There is the segment 5. Now, we will provide the value set. Now we will provide the value set. So that is value set name. We will give OPS, MBNY company, operations, operation company. Okay. And the list of, I will select list of values as it is, and the security type as non-hierarchical security, and the maximum size. So maximum size I will take as 2. That will be from 1 to say up to 10 I can create company. So I will taking that. You can take 3, 4 as business required, as per business requirement. You can take as per that. So I am taking 2, and the validation type will be independent. Save the same, and then create next. Then OPS division. And operation division, that is list of values again, the security hierarchical as non-hierarchical security, the format type is character, and the maximum size I will take a 3, and it's an independent one, other things is okay. I say, and then I will create another one, that is account, and sorry that I will create OPS accounts operations account, the list of value I will say non-hierarchical. And the list of maximum size, I'm taking 4. And the validation type as independent. Save the same. And create next. Then I will create OPS as product. Product. Operations. Product, that is again I will select as non-hierarchical, and the maximum size I will take 3, and that to an independent one. Save. Last not least, so we have created total value set 1, 2, 3, 4 value set, and in intercompany we will use the company as a value set. So from here. So in company display, I will select company as a display as 2, and the description size is 25 and 10. I will select as COOPS as my company first. Then I will select division OPS. That is division. Then in accounts, I will select as operations. So, operation account, there we are. And in product, I will say OPS. OPS, OPS product. Then intercompany, I will select OPS company. Now in company, open the same. Operations, security enabled, range required, have value set OK. Then in division, open. That is 3. Description size should be 25. In operation, accounts, so size is 4 and the description size should be 25. And in product, taking product as 3 and the size is 50 and 25. It's okay. Now, then I will select company again. Open intercompany. So it's 225. Maximum is 10. Save. Again, I will check it down. Yeah, 10 and 25. Now I will apply flexible qualifier. So you can see company while opening that. So enable insertable, display, updatable, and indexed. These should be enabled, right? Now, so default value, you can came back out here. You want a default value to be a, say company 01 should always default while selecting code combination. You can provide the default value out here. So default value will be there, right? So now I will provide the flex field qualifier. So company, in company, I will provide balancing segment. This attributes is used to identify the balancing segment, right? So I will select out here. You should then in division, by selecting the division, and I will provide as my cost center. So I'm selecting the same and save. Now in accounts, what will be the qualifier? The natural account segment qualifier, right? So total 5 segment, the values will be defined. So that is the natural segment qualifier. And we will save the same. Now, intercompany qualifier. So I will provide the same intercompany. So intercompany qualifier, save the same and close. I will recheck again qualifier. So you can see the natural account has been given provided, and to the division, the qualifier is cost center. So on that basis, we can prepare the reports on the division basis. And in the company, so it is a primary balancing segment. You can say balancing segment qualifier. So that is the topmost. So we will save the same. Now we will close. Now we will allow dynamic insert and cross validation segment. We will enable the same. So, and there is a freeze flex field definition. Once you get to modify your structure and the segment, you must freeze your flex field definition and save your changes. When you do so, your flex field it is freeze right now, compile. So it will activate as soon as I select freeze flex field definition. So it create a caution. Make sure that you do not want to make any more changes to the flex field segment definition before you freezing the flex field. And unfreezing and changing the definition later could affect the validity of existing data for your flex field. It's creating a caution and a warning. You should take care before any compilation, before compilation. If I say okay, so you can see now the compile get activated now. Now we can compile the same. So I will select to compile. Now I compile. Through SRS window, I will see the compiling flex field definition. So flex field complete successfully. We will go to SRS window, view request. Fine. So it has been completed successfully. You can see that. Now we will re-navigate to our accounting, general ledger accounting. So the navigation is set up. from general ledger super user responsibility set financials flex field key segment and search for general ledger. It is general ledger accounting flex and our is OPS accounting flex field. So it has been freezed, enabled, and dynamic insertion is also enabled. So you can see our segment. Total segment is company, division, account, product, intercompany. Segment 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 segment. And the value set is OPS company, OPS division, operation account, OPS product, and OPS company. We had assigned the same to intercompany. So by this way, we have created a chart of accounts structure in the Oracle EBS. And tomorrow session, we will create values in the value sets. So thank you. That's it for today. Thank you.